you know, a baby vlogger. Laura is sleeping, my girlfriend is sleeping. I'm gonna try my best to be better at vlogging. Starting today. I'm up early. I have a photo shoot. When I go to a photo shoot, I like to dress really comfortable, but still cute. I'm gonna wear these pants I thrifted. They're like big baggy dress pants and they're wool, so they're warm. And probably some type of, this is my closet. Probably some type of button down so that when they do the makeup, they don't have to pull something over and mess up their makeup. Okay, I'm gonna get dressed. So this is where a majority of jobs are. In LA, downtown, which if you live here, you know, is not the best area. I'm here, this is my oatmeal. Or I am always early. This is, not sure if I get locked in this elevator or not. I'm always early. Probably the first person here. Got my little brekkie. I always have oatmeal. Makes me full. This is terrifying. Oh. I've actually shot in this studio before. I think for bridal once. And then I'll get my side of the—
whoa, striking.
I mean, if you do want to do color, we could do the green that would match the stems, but probably not the green. Yeah. Let's just hold all of this up
to her. The, like, beautiful ones, I don't know. It's looking gorgeous.
Yeah.
Wow.
That's
gorgeous.
So good.
Am I having a glass of wine tonight?
I think so.
This is so nice. Yours is
baby, what is it?
It's Alice.
What?
Oh. Not Carl's Jr.
Wow.
Take a picture, take a picture.
Me and Laura are going to Rumble class. It's Saturday morning. I'm doing a whole vlog of the week.
Oh, I love that.
I'm gonna try.
This is a big moment for me. I haven't worked out in a long time.
I'm very tired. Let's do it.
Is the thing of you with the blanket has?
No.
This boxing is about to happen. I haven't been here in a very long time.
My gloves. Apparently they don't sell water. So we're gonna be sharing, honey. Wow.
Good job, baby.
No, if I got him.
He's not on the wall anymore.
He's not in the tissue, though.
Oh, Laura.
Well, me and Laura are going to a meeting right now, and we got into the parking garage, and I see my dream car. I don't know if you're ready. It's a pink Range Rover and it's a convertible. Maybe one day.
You could totally get that car. It's like costs a little bit more than what you have and it's just a wrap.
Is it a wrap? Oh yeah, I guess that's true.
Yeah, I'd get you the wrap as a birthday gift.
How much is a wrap?
Probably like $2,000 to $4,000.
Really?
Yeah.
Still expensive.
Like I said, I do it as a birthday gift.
That's still an expensive birthday gift.
Not like you haven't bought me stuff.
That's true. Nice bag you got there.
Exactly.
We're going to go get him, Tiger, in Culver City, and we don't know.
The elevator's here.
Nice. Irish step dance music.
Yeah.
Unless, like, she was really, really young, like Destiny's Child. Facts. You know what I mean? Like, she was coming up. So she had a, like, you know, had fire. But Beyonce was like, I'm Beyonce. And she didn't have to explain herself.
She just got rid of the two. She said, Destiny's Child, you too. No, you're not here anymore. Bye.
Bye-bye.
See ya.
You know?
See ya. Kelly, goodbye.
Carter's
Michelle,
calling me.
Ya.
Hold on.
Oh, it's the bell.
So I just got home from a photo shoot and Laura is stuck in traffic. Her ETA is like an hour and a half. So I decided it's time to add to the vlog that I keep on forgetting to film. This is going to be the most chaotic video because it's all over the place. It's like a week of vlogging. But I need to take off the makeup from the shoot and then start prepping dinner. For Laura, I think we're gonna make steak fajitas, which is kind of our best meal that we make. Let's begin. My get unready routine is the same every day. I get some of these little cotton pad thingies, a few of those, okay? And then we're gonna open a new one of these. I use Bioderma. Hello. I personally like to get this done as quickly as possible. So I get two of them wet and I just go in at the exact same time. I'm exhausted. I did so many outfits today. It's a really good workout though. I'm not complaining. This is just going to be an ASMR moment. I don't have anything to say. Somebody commented on my TikTok today and pointed out that I haven't posted in a week and that they miss me. And while that's really sweet, I've been like depressed for a few days. So that's the reason why I haven't posted anything. Like I have things to edit, but it's just like too much brain power, but I'm feeling better today. It's just because I'm PMSing and like every time I'm about to start my period, Laura and I both got some really good news the other day that we'll be really excited to share with you guys. It's work related, but it's a pretty big accomplishment for us and something that we've been kind of like hoping and like praying for months, honestly, like a really long time. I then evaluate my skin. Is it like doing okay? Or I think I missed a little spot. It doesn't taste good, by the way. No. Okay. So then I kind of evaluate my skin and I'm like, okay, is it like doing okay? Or am I getting a little clogged pores to determine which face wash I use. Right now, I think it looks pretty good. Like, this is all scarring for me because I used to have cystic acne, so I have a little bit of scarring, but I feel like the texture looks really good right now. So I don't need to use my medicated face wash, which is sodium sulfamide. This stuff is prescription only. And it's really expensive, but ultimately this has ended up saving my skin. I don't know what it is. It's kind of like, well, it's antibacterial, it's antimicrobial, and like I've had fungal acne, I've had bacterial acne, cystic acne, hormonal acne, I've had all of that. And I don't know, this just like keeps it good. It has a little grain to it. I think that it like gets that extra layer of like sebum, is that how you say it? Off of your skin. And sometimes I'll just use like a tiny pea size amount and like mix it with this, which is it's actually made by my esthetician Sarah Ford. She is amazing. Like I I started going to her when she first came to LA. She was like, hey, like, can I give you a free facial? And it was just like a whatever thing. And now she like does skincare for like some of the biggest celebrities. She's amazing. She's a healer. Her product's great. I'm really sensitive. Sometimes I'll mix them. But, you know, today we're just gonna use hers. Well, maybe. No, I don't need it right now. Just relax. Relax. Everybody relax. It does, the sulfur kind of dries out your skin, so you have to be a little bit careful. For me and my skin, like, my biggest lesson is just, like, don't overdo it. Products that are popular that messed up my skin are as follows. Anything Drunk Elephant. If you're not 11 years old, don't use it. I feel slightly guilty saying that because Drunk Elephant was like one of the first big PR packages I got years ago. But I stand by that. Like, it's so bad. I use the disposable, like, Clean Skin Club towels. I know there's a lot of influencers who are like, oh my god, those are pointless, like, just use a regular towel. No, I won't do it. These are amazing. And we live in an apartment complex where we share a washer and dryer with like the whole building. So even if I'm cleaning my towel, like, I don't know, it just doesn't feel clean. This feels funky fresh. Okay. Next thing is Peter Thomas. The last time I had like an insane, just like messed up skin problem, maybe I will include pictures for you guys. I have like a cystic acne thing that was like food and whatever. The last time I had an issue, it was like fungal. And I'm very sensitive, like I'm allergic to gluten, wheat, yeast. I'm allergic to yeast, okay? And I got a little sample of Peter Thomas Roth Cloud Cream. By the way, next thing I use, hyaluronic acid. Everybody should use it. It's just for hydration. It's great. I use The Ordinary. It's very simple, good price point. Great. A sample of the Peter Thomas Roth like cloud cream, and I was using it and I was like, okay, and I kept using it, but I was like, oh, I've seen these little bumps on my skin, I didn't know what was going on. Anyway, fast forward, I should have checked the ingredients because the second ingredient in that is yeast. Who does that? Whatever. Anyway, his other products are also like full of like perfumes and whatever. They absolutely suck. The other product that really messed up my skin is those watermelon dew drops from, I don't even remember, I don't know the brand, like, they went viral. I got them. Again, it's like full of like sugars and perfumes and anything that has like fatty acid or like sugars, or it just like feeds yeast and like, yeah, not good. The last thing I use, yes, the last thing, I don't have a crazy skincare. Which is what keeps my skin healthy now, is being discontinued. And like, like, kind of been gatekeeping it. And like, I don't want to say it now, but I also just ordered like 10 on Amazon because they're discontinued. But e.l.f. Who knew the best moisturizer ever was like this cheap ass one from e.l.f. It's not a cream, okay? It's like a jelly, it's like a gel type thing, I guess. I'm telling you right now, if you have fungal acne problems and you have a cream moisturizer, throw it away and just go get this, or try to get something that doesn't have any fatty acids in it or like creams or anything. I think there's like something comparable that they just released, but I haven't tried it yet, so I'm not gonna say that it's like the same as this one, but I'm gonna order it and give it a try. The next thing I do is for the products that are really great products that I don't want to use on my face because my face is very temperamental. I have like this Marvel anti-aging thing with Blue Scorpion Peptides and Mario, which is like one of my favorite brands, Hyaluronic. And this stuff, both of these, I just, you know, give a good squirt. A little bit here. A little Mario, this is vitamin C. This looks like a lot, but that's because I go like this. And I just do, I put this skincare all over my neck and my chest. And I wish I started this when I was much younger, but it's never too late to start caring for yourself. Because I'm not going to break out here and it's, you know, these are all anti-aging products and like good for your skin. So that's my get unready with me. And now I have to go cut some onions and make dinner. So ciao.
So I wasn't going to film the cooking, but can someone please explain? Is my bell pepper pregnant? What? I feel so invasive doing this. What in the world is going on here? What is going on?
Look who it is. Things.
You can use mine.
I need to buy one. I have my own.
This is me still working on the same single vlog.
Man, I'm hungry. I had blood drawn from me today. Oh. Blood drawn from me today. Oh. I thought you were gonna cook for once.
So what's going on with our little baby bell?
What happened to our bell pepper?
This was growing inside of the red one.
Wow. It's crazy.
Good.
Smells the same as the others. Yeah. Apparently it's edible.
Yeah, of course.
Oh my god.
I don't want to eat it like that.
Oh come on.
I like it cooked. You eat it.
I am. I'm good. Let's try it.
That was good. Yeah.